And here's my answer. If it's integer, we do what we did before. Otherwise, we go into a loop until the sum of the times is greater than or equal to the floating point number that was passed in. So now I think we got a pretty good handle on timing our functions. Another interesting question would be, how many assignments did we take along the way? Not just how long did they take? Now, if our program had been structured using four statements rather than using the big generator expression, we could do it like something like this. We could say we're going to count the number of assignments, we're going to start the count at zero, and then every time we go through an ordering, we're going to increment the count by one. You know, you might say we want to increment the count by five because we've assigned each of the five houses one of the colors, but I'm counting that as one. You can choose which one you want to go on. And then we just have a structure like that and we can keep track of the counts. And that will work fine, and it's not too bad, but it bothers me a little bit that we had to do such violence to this program, that we had this program, we had to go in and so many places, interrupt it, and put in so many statements. And I wanted to see, can we separate that out a little bit?